and welcome. It's Helen Cummins here, and today I have an interview with Sylvia Ennis, Mallorca's life coach. I'm delighted to welcome Sylvia here, another Irish woman, and she's been living on the island many years, and we're going to hear more about her life here in Mallorca.
Good morning, Helen. Thank you so much for inviting me to your home today. It's an honor and pleasure to be here with you.
Thank you, Sylvia.
So I'm originally from Ireland. I've been living on the island for 26 years now.
Wow.
I came in the summer of 95, fell head over heels in love with a Spanish man, had a whirlwind romance that summer. I was supposed to go back to Ireland in the September and ended up staying. My husband is now, he's from Salamanca. We got married in 2010, and we have one little boy, Max, who's 10 years old.
Brilliant. And you work together, right?
Yes, we work
also
together.
You have a very successful restaurant business.
Yes, we have restaurants in Palma Nova. We have three restaurants, and I divide my time with the coaching and looking after the restaurants as well.
And Max's Garden, no? Opened
yes.
two or three years ago.
Five years ago already,
yes,
wow.
Yes, so it's very successful.
Very successful, yeah. We're number one in TripAdvisor, and lots of healthy eating. We use lots of products from Mallorca. And my son, he goes to a British school. He goes to King Richard's in Port Dalles. And as a family, we love to hike. We do a lot of hiking here on the island.
Super.
And
you're living in Costa de Blanes.
Yeah.
Why did you choose Costa de Blanes?
We moved to Costa de Blanes 20 years ago. It's
wow.
up in the mountain. It's a really remote area. It's very quiet, yet it's very close to Port Dalles. It's close to my son's school, the businesses, 10 minutes from Palma. I love it because it's very cosmopolitan, like as Mallorca is. We have on our street alone, we have Irish neighbors, English, Spanish, German, Mallorquin.
Does it have Russian. A community feeling in
yes,
Costa
de
Blanes?
Yes, it does. Well, I've been living there a long time. In the beginning, no, but after a while, yes. So
you know a lot of people and you mix
mingle in and we have barbecues and we get together and things like that.
Super.
And it has a great hike because as a family, we love to hike. So you can hike from like Costa de Blanes all the way through to Calvia.
Wow.
Which is really nice.
And it's also the proximity of it to Port Dalles. Puerto Port Dalles obviously is a beautiful
yeah.
place. Port Dalles now. And also you have a lot of international schools
exactly.
just literally on your doorstep,
yes,
right?
Very, very, very cosmopolitan area. People from all walks of life go to those schools. You have the International Agora, King Richard's. You have Queen's College just a little bit up then.
So it's a good, it's really accessible to Palma as
oh,
well.
Yeah, yeah. In 8 minutes you're in yeah. Palma.
Do you have the feeling that you're a little bit kind of in the countryside almost? Because
yes.
you have these hiking
you do.
Routes
you do.
Behind.
Yes, it's very remote yeah. area, very quiet and like 2 minutes then near everything. A little bit quiet
yeah.
out of the way.
Is there anything about the area you don't like?
Not really. I would like a bigger garden. I have a small garden, so maybe in the future we might buy a finca somewhere in the north of the island or somewhere and grow our own little
your own
organic
huerto.
Yes,
oh, yeah.
huerto,
oh,
yes.
Yeah.
But no, I love the area. I wouldn't change anything about living in
yeah.
the area.
One of the things I like about it a lot is that it's just so accessible.
Yes.
Plus, I think you get more sunshine there than anywhere else on the
That's
island.
That's what they say, yes.
Yes, it's always, because even when we leave our house here,
yeah.
and we're not that far, it's 10 or 15 minutes, it always seems to be so much
sunny
warmer
side, yeah.
there.
They call it the little sunny side of
yeah.
Mallorca. Yeah.
yeah.
That's very
so,
true.
So, I mean, this is nice in wintertime as well.
Yes.
Sylvia, you meet a lot of newcomers to the island. What are the typical problems or issues that newcomers face when they come to Mallorca?
Yeah, new people come into the island. I think one of the things I generally see is the language barrier. The language barrier can be an issue. Families seeking out schools, they don't know which school to send their children to. Another one would be the area, which area to live in.
Mm-hmm.
Paperwork, the language barrier, again, it's a big issue. Sometimes it can be a cultural shock for some people because they have this mindset of moving to a new country that everything is going to be the same as it is in their previous country, and that is not necessarily the thing. So I would advise people to come with cultural intelligence mindset.
Oh, that's a nice phrase. So it's really, Mallorca is because it's so cosmopolitan.
Yes.
You need to be open to
and things
experience.
Are slower. Things are slower here on the island,
But that's good.
It's great.
Because many people want to have that lifespan.
Yes, yes.
So it can be an advantage. But if you come here with a fast mindset, it can be very frustrating.
Yes. And then after a while, people do tend to slow down, though.
It's true. It's true. Things move at a slower pace and you get used to it.
Yes.
In your business of life coaching, what kind of problems do you help people to overcome?
So I kind of have like two different types of categories of clients. I'd have the first category, the client would be somebody who knows exactly what it is that they want to achieve. They have a big goal, a big desire, a big dream, and they know what they want, but they don't know how to get there.
Okay.
So it could be lack of procrastination, it could be fear, it could be feeling like not enough confidence, false beliefs about themselves. So I just show them a little bit of a system or a formula to achieve what it is that they want. Then I have the other type of client who is feeling a little bit stuck, Helen, or at a crossroads in their life, and they don't know where to go. They know that they want something more, but they're not sure what it is. So what I do is I help them go on an inward journey, create a vision of what it is that they want, and then empower them to take the steps and create that. There is a myth around life coach. Oh, life coach helps people fix their problems. And that's a myth. That's not necessarily true. I think everybody needs a mentor or a coach. Because what we do is we help people grow, expand, transform, become the best version of themselves and really master their life in every area, be it the health, relationships, career, time, money and freedom, and to become an overall joyful, happy person.
Great. So you do individual coaching.
Yeah.
You do workshops.
Yes.
You run masterclasses.
Yes.
So there's many options for
yes,
people
of course.
Depending whether they want to just have a very individualized program or whether they want to participate with other people and maybe share the knowledge and share.
Exactly.
Is it,
yes, that's the way it works. One-on-one VIP coaching, or if you don't like you prefer to be in a group, we do small groups of 6 to 8 people.
And that's a great opportunity for other people to meet each other.
To meet each other.
And they're on a similar growth path.
Yes, like-minded people, of course.
Great.
Yeah.
What kind of advice would you give people who are planning to move here? I mean, you said about being open-minded culturally and, and stuff like that. Is there tips that you would say after all these years of living in Mallorca, seeing many people come and go and change? What would you advise people?
I think the first thing would be do is to seek out a really great place to live.
Right.
Yeah, that's
finding
the first
thing. Fit for them, right?
Okay. That's the first thing, the foundation, a nice place to live. The second thing I would advise would be to get an NIE number, your residencia. It's very important because if you don't have a residencia, you can't open a bank account. I think you can't even buy a telephone if you don't have a residencia.
Yeah, without the NIE number. Yeah.
So that's very important. Definitely fit in with other locals. You know, learn about the culture about Mallorca, about the Mallorquin and the Spanish people, because sometimes as expats, we tend to stick together. I definitely would say join a group or a community, be it yoga or a gym, or there's loads of groups and communities out there, hiking, you know, bicycle. Yeah, and knock on your neighbor's door, introduce yourself, just dive right in.
Yeah. People tend to be more open here on the island.
Of course,
new
and
people.
Learn a language. Definitely learn the language. Learn, sign up and to do a Spanish course, because again, then you meet other people like you who are learning the language and are new to the island.
Great.
Yeah.
Sylvia, thank you so much. I'm sure we could talk for another 2 hours.
Yes.
But it's been great to have you here today. And thank you for coming in and continued success.
Thank you very much, Helen.
Thank you
so much. Thank you.